In this lesson, we're going to look at protecting our databases, specifically Amazon DynamoDB and the Amazon Relational Database Service. So starting off with DynamoDB, this is our NoSQL database where you create tables. Our tables can be encrypted. They're encrypted at rest, so your data is encrypted at rest within your table, and you can specify the key that you use for that encryption. Now, you can also connect to your DynamoDB table using a gateway endpoint. So remember, that's one type of VPC endpoint that you can use so that you can connect your instances, both in public or private subnets, to your DynamoDB table using private IP addresses. So the instances will use a private address and they don't get routed over the internet. Now, you also might want to connect from your corporate data center. In that case, you can either connect over the internet with SSL TLS connections, or you can connect using a connection like a VPN or a direct connect to AWS. And then from there, you might use a gateway endpoint to go across to your DynamoDB table. Now, in all these cases, we're using TLS encryption, so we have encryption in transit and encryption at rest. The KMS key that you use for DynamoDB can be AWS owned, and that's the default option and it's free, or you can have an AWS managed key or a customer managed key. DynamoDB supports identity-based policies, not resource-based policies, so you can control who is allowed to access DynamoDB for API actions. Now, moving on to RDS, this is the Amazon Relational Database Service, and it runs on EC2 instances within a VPC. Encryption at rest can be enabled. Now, RDS also uses EBS volumes for storing its data. When you enable encryption at rest, that will include the DB storage, the backups, the read replicas that you create from your database, and any snapshots you take of your main database or your read replicas. It's really important to understand that you can only enable encryption for RDS when you create your database. You can't disable it either if you enable it when you create your database and you change your mind later on. So essentially, you can't change the encryption status of your database following encryption. With RDS, it uses AES 256 encryption. Now, for RDS for Oracle or SQL Server, you can use transparent data encryption or TDE. KMS is used for managing your encryption keys with RDS. So let's have a look at the various ways that we can protect access to our databases. So as I said, RDS will run within a VPC, so you can have your endpoint as a public or a private endpoint. In this case, we have an IP address, and this is a public endpoint, so we're able to access our database straight from the internet. Now, we can also have security groups attached to our database. Our application servers might also have security groups. So if we're connecting via an application server rather than the direct to the database, as in the example at the top there, then we're using a security group to control the port that we're allowing our application to access the database on. We can also use SSL TLS encryption, so we have the encryption in transit as well as encryption at rest. Now, additionally, when we encrypt our database, remember the database volume, that's the EBS volume used by RDS, will be encrypted, and any snapshots you create. And they'll be also using the same key. The snapshot will have the same key as the database volume. Now, encryption at rest is using AES 256 encryption. Now, you can't have an encrypted replica of an unencrypted database instance, or an unencrypted replica of an encrypted database instance. So essentially, your read replicas will have the same encryption status as the primary they're a replica of. Now, the same KMS key is used if the replica is in the same region as the primary. If it's in a different region, you can specify a different KMS key. You can't restore an unencrypted backup or snapshot to an encrypted DB instance. So what if we want to change the encryption status of our DB? Well, the key thing to remember here is firstly, you can't for your existing DB instance. So here we have an unencrypted database instance. There's no way I can encrypt this database instance. But what I can do is from the unencrypted volume, I'm going to create a snapshot. Now that will also be unencrypted. Then I'm going to copy the snapshot and I'm going to change the encryption status. Then restore the snapshot to a new RDS database instance. Now our new instance is encrypted, but it's a different instance, so it has a different endpoint. So your applications will need to look to the new endpoint now.